range. So how does that make LU decomposition method a better method to use than using gas elimination? So let's go and see how that works out. So if you look at Nagy-Gassin method, so let's look at Nagy-Gassin elimination method. Or let's go and see that how much time Nagy-Gassin method would take if I was going to find the inverse of an A matrix, inverse of a n by n A matrix. So in that case, I'll have forward elimination. Okay, forward elimination takes the amount of time. Forward elimination takes is approximately equal to C times N cube divided by 3. So the amount of time forward elimination takes in order to the computation time is C times N cube divided by 3, approximately equal to C N cube, where C is simply the time to conduct a flop. Okay, multiply divide flop. What do I mean by that? C is the amount of time which it takes to conduct a multiplication division floating point operation. So it is proportional to n cubed by 3. So if n is the number of equation and n by n is the order of the A matrix, then the amount of time which is going to take to do forward elimination in the Nagy-Gassin method will be proportional to Cn cubed divided by 3. There are certain assumptions which are involved in this, is that we are assuming that multiply and divide floating point operations are taking the same amount of time, which is not actually true. We're also neglecting how many floating point operations we have to do of addition and subtraction, although to take a little bit less time. So having taken these assumptions, that's why I put the word approximately here, because this is not exactly the number of floating point operations you are doing in the forward elimination part of the Gauss elimination method. This is only the multiply-divide floating point operations you are doing. Also, you are then assuming that multiply and divide takes the same amount of time, and you're also neglecting the addition and subtraction. But this is not a bad assumption to make here, that how much time forward elimination takes. In a similar spirit, back substitution takes approximately Cn squared divided by 2 amount of time. So if somebody was going to say that, hey, for doing one set of equation, it will take C times n cubed by 3. For back substituting, it will take Cn squared divided by 2 amount of time, where C is the time it takes to conduct a single multiply-divide floating point operations. Then I can see that the total time it's going to take, so total time it is going to take to find the inverse of A matrix will be Cn cubed divided by 3 plus Cn squared divided by 2. So this is going to be the amount of time it's going to take to do a single forward elimination and back substitution. So I'll have n times that, n times Cn cubed divided by 3 plus Cn squared by 2 will be the amount of time it's going to take for me to do the to find out the inverse of A, because I have to do this forward substitution and back substitution n times. Now what about LU decomposition method? So let's do it just on a separate place here. In the LU decomposition method, what's going to happen is that the amount of time I have to do forward elimination. So forward elimination is going to take the same amount of time as it takes for Nagy-Gassin method, because I'm using the same steps of forward elimination to do the LU decomposition. So it will be Cn cubed divided by 3. Then also, of course, I have to do forward substitution. And that's going to take approximately Cn squared by 2. Because forward substitution will be same as back substitution. We just talked about that back substitution takes Cn squared by 2 time. So then back substitution will take approximately Cn squared by 2 time also. So you can see that LU decomposition is going to take more time, because we have forward elimination steps, forward substitution steps, and back substitution steps if we're just doing this once, because the total time will be Cn cubed divided by 3 plus Cn squared by 2 plus Cn squared by 2, because this is the time which is this part here is the additional time which you have to take in terms of in LU decomposition method. But the thing is that what you are not seeing is that this this is the time which is going to take to do the LU decomposition method, or the LU decomposition of the A matrix. So this has to be done only once. However, this part here will have to be done n times, because I'll have to do the forward substitution and back substitution n times, because the LU decomposition only has to be done once. So if I, this is the total time it's going to take to do LU decomposition. So this one becomes Cn cube divided by 3 plus Cn cube, and that becomes 4Cn cube divided by 3. So you can already see that the if I try to write down what is the time taken by Gaussian elimination, so if I look at Gaussian elimination time, and I divide it by the LU decomposition time, what is that equal to? The Gaussian elimination time is n times Cn cube divided by 3 plus Cn square divided by 2. And the LU decomposition time is 4n cube, 4cn cube divided by 3. And this is approximately, if n is large, then this quantity here becomes small as compared to this quantity here. So I can always write it as approximately equal to cn cube divided by 3. So I'm going to neglect this term here. And divided by 4cn cube divided by 3. So what I'm going to get is this and this cancels, c and c cancels, and that's n divided by 4. So what it's basically telling me, that the amount of time Gaussian elimination is going to take to find the inverse of a matrix will be n by 4 times what LU decomposition is going to take in order to be able to do the finding the inverse of a matrix. So you can very well see if n is equal to 1,000, let's suppose, your Gaussian elimination time divided by the LU decomposition time is going to be 250. Because n divided by 4, 1,000 divided by 4 is 250. So Gaussian elimination is going to take 250 times more what LU decomposition will take to find the inverse of a matrix. So this is the reason why LU decomposition is favored over Gaussian elimination when you have multiple right-hand sides, as would be the case when you are trying to find the inverse of a matrix. And that's the end of this segment.